I love you, Allah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Ramadan Kareem. May you all, Ya Rab, have a very blessed and fruitful month, inshallah. I have to share the story with you. I've actually been wanting to share it with you guys for quite a while. But tonight something happened that I was like, no, I have to share this with you guys. So alhamdulillah, last year I was very blessed and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala invited me to his house for Hajj. And alhamdulillah, we were very lucky to be with, you know, a specific group of people where we were able to get these very special dates or the Ajwa of Medina from a very special garden there in Medina. And I kept those dates. This is like last August, right? Almost about a year ago now, less than a year. Took them with me back home to Egypt after Hajj, and then I took them back with me here to the USA. And they've been with me in the fridge for quite a while until there was just a few left in a Ziploc. And they've just been sitting there in the fridge, right? Fast forward, maybe till I would say beginning of February, I homeschool my kids, right? So I ran into this group of wonderful, like, homeschooling moms, and they have a co-op, and it was my first time to meet them. They're about an hour's drive away from me. So anyway, short story. After a couple of weeks, I'm sitting with one of the moms in the kitchen, like, while, you know, where the kids were doing cooking and whatnot. And subhanAllah, she starts talking about, you know, the Ajwa of Medina and how she's always like really longed to taste it, but she's never ever had it. She doesn't know what it tastes like. So subhanAllah, I remembered the Ajwa that was in my fridge, right, from Hajj. So I went back home, and then the following Thursday when I was going, I got the Ziploc for her with those, you know, dates. And as I was giving it to her, it hit me so hard. I was like, subhanAllah, Ya Rabbi, like, I went to Hajj to get these dates and carry them across the world from another continent, right? From, you know, Saudi Arabia to Egypt, from Egypt all the way back to USA, keep them preserved in my fridge for another God knows how many months, because they were her risk. You know what I'm saying? Like, these dates were hers. They were grown and it had her name on it. This lovely, lovely Hispanic Muslim sister. SubhanAllah, it hit me and I was like, you understand that these were always yours from the very beginning, and I was just, you know, Allah was just using me to keep them for you. That's all. I'm just delivering. I'm just like a male woman, basically. And we got both so emotional, we started crying. That was the first part of the story. And from it, I would tell you, your rizq is already destined for you. It doesn't matter if, you know, it doesn't matter where you are in life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has your rizq preserved and saved for you. Even if it's going to come from across the world, from the other side, across the seas and the oceans. If you haven't yet gotten married and, you know, you're wondering and you're worried about your rizq is written. Your spouse is going to come to you at the right time, from the right place. The job that you're longing for, the child that you're dying to have. SubhanAllah, rizqakum fis samaa wa ma tu'adun. Right? That's the first part of the story. This was about 4 weeks ago when I gave her the dates. Today, I'm coming back from Tarawih, and I run into one of my lovely friends who has just returned from Umrah. And she catches me in the parking lot as we're leaving, and she tells me, I have something for you. And she gives me this little bag, right? I gave those dates and they were very dear to me. I just want to show you what I got. A whole jar of Ajwa dates, the same ones I gave, subhanAllah. When you give from what you love, wallah al-azim, it never ever decreases. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give it back to you and more. This is double what I gave. Subhanak ya Rabb. Have trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and don't ever be a miser with Allah. Give from the best that you have and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will always reward you with even more, and min haythu la tahtasib, from where you wouldn't even imagine. Wallahi, I wasn't expecting this. And I mean, it's maybe something silly to you, it might be dates, but the concept is that when you really give and from something that you love, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give back, multiply by so much more. Have faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that your rizq will come to you, doesn't matter where you are, and give from the best of what you have. Wa arullahu min anfusikum khayran. It's Ramadan. Give, 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 and have that faith, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.